Hey, it's Jodie here from The 7 Effect. I've got a blank canvas, so I thought I'd share with you a model that I've been playing around with some of my clients. And I think right now more than ever, the reason I'm playing around with this model is because we all need to understand how to become what I call a high value human. And what I mean by that is the kind of human who can be an asset, not a liability, in any situation. High value humans are the types of people who seem to just land on their feet no matter what the circumstances are. They can win dream jobs, they can lead teams with ease, and they can launch businesses and have success right away. Why? Because they know how to get results and deliver value without excessive effort. And so when it comes to exploring the high value human matrix, there are two continuums that we'll look at. There's the energy, which is how much you contribute, the energy that you give or take from any situation, and the effort required by you to produce that energy. And here's the thing, what I'm sharing with you is not like a personality profiling tool. You don't become one of these people. It's not about who you are, but more so how you are showing up, how you're operating. So let's unpack it, shall we? Well, firstly, we'll look at the effort continuum this way. And there are people who by nature will put in lots of effort and work hard. And there are also people who have cracked the code on how to get great results with less effort. And so they like to work smart. Hot tip, the key to working smart is really understanding the 80-20 principle, which is all about low effort, high rewards. So we've got that one. And then we look down this way at energy. So in the bottom half, we have people who consume more energy than they give. I don't know if you've ever been out to lunch with someone and then after it's over, you go, oh my God, I am exhausted. Get me away from that person. And then there are other people who create energy. And these are the ones that you go out to lunch with and you come away and you go, oh my God, I feel like I'm on fire. I can't wait to do something or take action, or you just feel alive. And so when we understand the quadrants around energy and effort, we end up with these four different places that we can all operate from. And again, as I said, this isn't about who you are, but how you are being. So up here, when we're working hard and we're creating energy, we're adding value, it's the space that I call the grinder. And so when we're operating in a grinder type space, we tend to believe that the world is what I make it. Sorry about all the sounds in the background there. Grinding or being in the grinder space is exceptional for taking responsibility, grabbing the bull by the horns, and making things happen. In the grinder zone lands your workaholics and your control freaks. I've done my time there. The problem is it's not a sustainable space because this is where burnout can happen. Or relationship breakdowns as well, because let's face it, trying to keep up to the standards of a grinder can be really challenging. So down here, like the grinders, this is a space where people will work hard, but they tend to consume more energy than they contribute. It's the groaner zone. And now the groaners aren't necessarily pessimistic or negative people. In fact, they're very lovely, kind people, and it's not even about people, as I said before, but spaces that we get into. But the problem in the groaner space is we get to the mindset where the world is hard. And what happens when we fall into the groaner space is we get to a point where we've rendered ourselves powerless. So we have the workaholics and the control freaks in the grinder zone. In the groaner zone, it's not sustainable either. Whoops, wrong one here. Because here we tend to be doing work that we don't necessarily want to be doing with a grudge or reluctantly because we feel like no matter what I say, it's not valued and I won't be listened to anyway. Now, the thing I love about the grinder and the groaner space is people are usually very honest and say, yep, that's totally me. Yep, that's totally me. And so moving these folks into this area is not that difficult. It's just about understanding what to do to make the shift. This space down here, however, where we are consuming more than we are contributing or creating, but we have cracked the code on working smart, is where the manipulator. And sadly, this does happen. People will work the system, manipulate situations for their own good. So the manipulator zone is a place where people are very focused on one core belief, the world owes me. And here, if you can imagine, you have people that have maybe felt like they've been hard done by or they've been taken advantage of and now they seek revenge and they want to take advantage or manipulate situations to get things back for themselves. And sadly, I think we're going to see right now with what's happening in coronavirus, some people will manipulate and take advantage of the situation and the current climate. There are other people who are grinding away like crazy, trying to build their business or stay afloat. And then there are others who are getting caught up in just groaning, rendering themselves powerless and saying, there's not much I can do. Ideally, though, we want to get up into this space because this is where we get closer to becoming a high-value human and become a magnifier. So the magnifiers, like the grinders, add a lot of value. They show up, they get results, and they contribute. They contribute more than they take, and they do it instead of working hard by working smart. And the magnifiers tend to operate on this belief that the world is our, and the word being our is very critical there, not my, the world is our oyster. Because unlike the manipulators, the magnifiers are not about themselves. They're about the bigger picture, the people around them and what they can do for their communities, their families, their organizations, whatever it might be, their clients, etc. And then we have right at the top, once we've really mastered the art of creating and contributing in a really smart 80-20 way, we have the high value humans. So whilst the magnifier is a great space to be, and I bet you've done your time here and you know how to take an idea and turn it into an innovation, or you know how to unpack a concept and turn it into a creation, what you want to be doing is really looking at mastery, which very few people do, and going, how do I master the art of becoming a high value human, an asset in any given situation, so that I am continually creating energy for those around me as well as myself by working smarter, not harder. So that's it. That's the how to be a high value human model. Well, it's really just unpacking the matrix. If you want to get the steps on how to actually get there, stay tuned. I'll be sharing that over the next few days. I hope you enjoyed this. Any questions, post them in the comments below as well. I'll be happy to answer them. Let me know what you think. Bye-bye.